Introduction to Civil Engineering. Today we will be looking into detail about this topic. And the syllabus, yesterday I have discussed with you. Now we are going to discuss module 1. And in that, Introduction to Civil Engineering, these topics will be theoretical. The whole 5 modules which you are going to study depends upon the Introduction to Civil Engineering, this content. So whatever you study, you will be going to apply in this title. So let us look into this module 1, and in Introduction to Civil Engineering, there is first content called Scope of Different Fields of Civil Engineering, and next thing is Role of Civil Engineers in Infrastructural Development. So these things we will be discussing today, and in next class I will be discussing the type of field in civil engineering, that is survey, building materials, construction technology. There are different branches in civil, so that we will discuss in further classes, but today I will be discussing short to the Introduction to Civil Engineering. And the term civil engineering, so you would have wondered that when the engineering existed in university. We know that the construction even started before the academic mode of teaching. So there were no academic mode of teaching formally, and there were no universities. Example, before 2000 and 3000 years back, the Egyptians built pyramid. So at that point of time, we don't have a university based education system. So currently what we are now, it was not there in the past. And in India we had Indus Valley civilization, and we had roads, infrastructure development, everything way before the concept of engineering. So currently we want to know that when an university started, how a curriculum is being started. Engineering is a professional engineering discipline that deals with design, construction and maintenance. These are the three major points the civil engineers deal with. First thing is design. Design in terms that before construction we have to have a vision. So what is required to be constructed? So that is known as design. You will be hearing that a plan before construction. So you need a plan and you need design. What materials you are going to construct? You can build a structure by using steel. Only by using the steel material you can construct all the components of the house. But you can use timber material. In United States, many places where it is prone to earthquake, they built wooden structures. So wood type construction can also be built, and concrete structure, we very well know about that, and this is worldwide a famous material. The second component which is being used by humans after water. So the consumption of water is the primary commodity in this world, and next to that, concrete is the next commodity which is being used by each and every human. So like that, there are different materials to construct a house. So before constructing you need design, and while constructing the civil engineer takes the responsibility to construct, and after construction you need maintenance. So soon after your house is come to exist, what happens? There will be some maintenance issues. So during those period the profession covers these areas, which may be physically and naturally built environment. It might be physically built by human, or it might be naturally built, but you will be preserving that. So certain things are being naturally built, and these civil engineers will preserve that. That is the only thing they are going to do. So this profession comes under civil engineering. And public work such as construction of roads, bridges, you very well know these two things, and canals. So the canal is a word which is a key word which is used in irrigation engineering. In a dam, the water will be stored, and that stored water will be distributed to each and every agricultural land by using this canal system. So in a house we know pipe, so the pipe transfers the water from the tank and it transfers to our tap everywhere. So like that, for an agricultural land, if you need water, canal transfers the water from the dam to each and every part of the irrigation system. And dams, construction of airport, sewage system. So not only construction of infra construction activities, but after construction each and every structure, say for example if you are constructing a building, from buildings you will be having daily discharge of sewage. From an industry you will be having daily discharge of their production. So whatever is running, it will have some discharge. So these discharge has to be collected in a certain system, and pipelines are required to be laid. So these pipelines are laid by these engineers, and structural components of building and railway lines. So all this construction comes under civil engineering. So if you are thinking about when the civil engineer is existed in India or around the world, so way before engineering, the engineering was first meant for the military people. So before well developed civilization, a well developed society, military people were the engineers. So for military purpose the engineering created initially, and further it slowly went to the people. And in olden days the word military engineer originated first, as he undertook the engineering task with reference to military role in the war. So you can see a picture here, there is a bridge built. So it is not a bridge which is constructed by using concrete or by wood, by using number of publics. So here you can see only military person who are constructing a bridge which is temporary, and it can be assembled and dismantled easily. So they are constructing a bridge like this. So we would not be seen this kind of bridges. So military people, not only in India, in all the countries, military people are the first engineers. They are constructing this for protecting the people. So if you want to protect the people inside the land, you have to protect your borders. So that is why before 6 months or 1 year, there was a border issue between India and China. So the Chinese people are constructing the roads there, and these were the issues of border. They are increasing their infrastructure facility in their border. So likewise, India has to increase their infrastructure. So they have to lay the roads for transporting the commodities. For that, the military people go the place where it is uncivilized. So these people does not work in a proper road or proper way to move, or there will be no ways. They will create the way. So it might be a dense jungle, or it might be a icy area. So these people go there and they don't have any facility. So if we are going from one place to another, we have a mode of transport called road, and we can go through by walk, we have a way. But these people don't have a way, they create the way. So that is why engineering is meant for them. So they created the land, so they protect the land, so they preserve the land. Then next type of engineering comes to exist. Okay, so in India we have military engineering service. So after your ECE studies, you can join military engineering service. That is also a part of Indian engineering service. That is IES exams are there. You can write those exam and work as a part of Indian military service. So this is an government organization, and this engineering service was way started after the independence. And the engineers undertook works other than military engineer was referred as civil engineer. At that point of time there was no branches in civil engineering. The person who is taking care of this border work and infrastructural work were the military engineers. And soon after that, public needs someone to help for their creation of their shelter. So someone need to work in order to get other basic needs, that is road, they need to walk, they need some drinking water facility, and they need water for irrigation facility. Slowly these people work are being taken by the civil engineers, and due to the demand of the people, number of engineer after that came. So mechanical engineer and electrical engineer, electronics. So we are not interested in who's first. So all our engineers, don't think like that, someone is first, we are second. It is not like that. Engineer, you are engineer, and nobody is first. Everyone should learn everything. All the engineering fields should be reached to all the engineers. This is what the current society requirement. So then slowly the requirement of the people, they need a bike to transport, a car to move from one place to another, and they need a communication facility, and they need something to store. So soon after that, different types of engineering came. Currently our college is going for robotics engineering, and the robotics branch is a next future level of requirement for the people. So everyone does need a robot. They are also interested, people, everyone are interested. You can see many of the Hollywood movies comes under this robotic study. Why? Because the robot can do works far better than men, and if you are in those studies, then the future is there. So whatever we have future at that area, engineering always moves like a river. So engineering is like a river. You people are engineers, you should move towards the requirement of the society, the requirement of the people. So whatever the requirement, you should move towards that, then you can be a successful engineer. Yes, being a civil engineer, we mean the engineering, know how and the task undertaken for the purpose of civil population. Then civil engineering came to exist for the requirement of civil population. Also you can see construction of a bridge here for the army tank. So there is a pre-assembled steel structure which is being constructed for the movement of military tank. Okay, so have you wondered which was the first university in the world to give engineering degree? So if you have wondered, then this is your answer. And this is the history of that. The first private college to teach civil engineering in the United States was Norwich University. This was in the time of 1819. At this time, so this was the university which is made for, not for public, it is meant for military college. So this is meant for military college, that is military engineering service, and this was the first private engineering college. And next thing is, first degree in civil engineering in United States was awarded by Rensselaer Polytechnic Institute in the year of 1935. So for public, so this is for military people, and this is for the public. So at the year of 1835, so the person who studied the engineering got degree in those period. And after that, the first woman, Nora Stanton, has got the first engineering degree in the year of 1905. These are the milestone of the engineering. And in earlier days, the engineer has a team like this, and they do surveying works. So let us see what is surveying work and what are all the things they do. So this is military engineering. While studying civil engineering, you should know also the military engineering. What they do is, they design, they built military works and maintain lines of military transport and communication. They are only meant for military communication, everything. So you can see a picture here that the military tank is laying a road here. So this road is not by bitumen and tar. So you can see tar roads, and this road is not constructed by those material. This is made by steel interlocking. So there is a vehicle here which is transporting this interlocking connection. So by this, the road is being laid in order to pass from one area to the other. And Indian Army Corps of Engineers was active since 1777. At this time, Indian Army Corps of Engineers was being started, and this is the logo for that. And during that time, in our country, there was three type of engineering centers, that is head centers. So first was Madras Sappers. So this was the first engineering union where a group of engineers were there in order to take care of all the country's work. And next, Bengal Sappers and Bombay Sappers. These three are the place where you find engineers, and from there these military people took care of all the whole Indian engineering works. And slowly the military engineering services is being further classified into border road organization. So this is an, if you want to go to Indian engineering service, you will be having works in this area. So the border road organization lays the road in all the borders. So in between India and Myanmar, in between India and Afghanistan or Pakistan or China, Sri Lanka, these are the border countries. Around 400 number of bridges is being constructed by these engineers, and around 50,000 kilometer of road is being laid by those engineers in the borders. So these engineers take care of these border oriented activities. And married accommodation project, this is a project called MAP project. Around 40 lakh of houses to be constructed by using this organization and the Survey of India. This is the Great Survey of India. So these people have surveyed the India. So whenever you go to a railway station, you can see the name of the station, and below that you can see plus mark, plus 21.0 meter, like that it will be written there. And in Bangalore you can see plus 890 meter, like that it you can see that in every station it will be there. So what is the meaning of that is, so plus in the sense it is higher elevation, it is higher elevated from the sea level. So if you find plus 800 meter, so that railway station is being located 800 meter above the sea level. So Indian railway lines has the height of each and every location. So Bangalore, what is the height from the sea level? So it is being measured by the Great Survey of India, that is Survey of India, and they have made all the survey. So what do you mean by survey is finding the height, finding the length, finding the distance, so which we will study in detail. And next thing is College of Military Engineering. In Pune you are having an institution called College of Military Engineering. It is a premium technical and tactical training institution of Indian Army Corps of Engineers. So if you want to join here, you will be trained in this engineering colleges. And next thing is, what is the role of civil engineer in infrastructure development? So I yesterday highlighted a word called infrastructure. So what I mean by infrastructure is not only laying roads. Here you can see a bridge here, and not only laying this kind of bridges here, it is also the development in computer science and the hardware and software component, and how we communicate, how that is electronic and communication, how well our communication and our development. See, currently we are having augmentation reality, virtual reality, and the things will come around us. So we will be in a different world, like that our communication is being changed. So these are all comes under the infrastructure development. And constructing the industries, and also the infrastructure, that is building construction, all comes under the infrastructure. So let us look into that. It can be defined as activities that provide society with services necessary to conduct daily life. So what are the things which is required in daily life? Everything comes under infrastructure. So you need milk daily. So how you deliver your milk, how you take the milk from the dairy and how you provide for that. So this is infrastructure. In different countries follow different mode of delivering this milk product. So you can see a powder type milk. So these are all is being invented from foreign countries. How they supply milk for some area. See, if a cow is there around 500 kilometers, they can transfer the cow milk from one area to another area. If an area which has to be supplied, which is far more than 1000 kilometers, then how you can supply the cow's milk to that part of land? Say for example, next these military people don't have any communication, so they will be not having this facility. So in that point of time, these people can have this bread and dairy industry, and they made the cow's milk into a powder and they stored into a packet, and they serve for more than 1000 or 1 lakh kilometer they can serve, and like that. Okay, so for simple milk I am saying, so what are the essential services you are using? Water and all the agricultural product, everything comes under infrastructure. How you deliver, how it is preserved, comes under the infrastructure. And to engage in a productive activity and development in country's economy, if you increase your infrastructure, and definitely your country's economy will get increased. Okay, in a country like India, the major infrastructural factors that are most significant in accelerating the pace of economic development are, the major parts are the energy. How you create energy? The energy is created by mechanical type energy, and you are having hydro power plant. So from that power plant you can produce electricity, and atomic power plant is available, and thermal power plant. How you create your energy? So in Arab countries they are using thermal power plant. Why? Because they have lots and lots of crude oil. By using their form of energy, they are creating the energy, and they supply for all the country, and day by day we have an increase of petrol and diesel. So they supply the energy and they create their country's infrastructure. So that is their base of infrastructure. And for some countries, the human might be the infrastructure. So the population might be the major backbone of a country, and agriculture might be backbone of some country. So like that, the energy has to be dealt, and transportation, finance. And here you can see a term, finance. Why? Finance is also dealing with a developing and developed country is different. So how well you have insurance? So if you are going to Canada, or if you are going to United States, Australia and all developed countries, there you have a mandatory insurance policy. So here, if you want, in India you can want, you can take insurance, or if you don't want, you can omit those insurance. So in foreign countries they have a well developed insurance policy for each and everything. We have insurance. So this is how it works. What is insurance? It is just part of money you are giving to someone in order to give the security. So they give security for you, you are going to spend money for that. So you receive security from them and you spend money. So purely it depends upon the money. So security is also given by money. So they will give, for those security they will give a lot of money for that. And this is the way finance happens. So a country is being developed in finance also, and banking also comes under this finance, and communication, education and health. A better health is required for good infrastructure. And for your exam point of view, they can ask infrastructure facilities. What are the infrastructure facility have to be improved? So these are the points. Road comes under infrastructure, airport, ports, railway, energy, how you transfer the electricity, and utilities, that is water, and milk, education, healthcare, social, all these things comes under infrastructure. So if you develop these things, if you develop each and everything, then your country will get a developed country. In Japan, you have a railway line. It has a speed of 500 kilometer or more. But now we are having in India around 150 to 180 kilometer per hour fastest train. And in other countries, you have high speed trains. How? Due to those infrastructural capability and the amount they spend. So by those things, they have the next level of railway lines and provision of water distribution system. So this picture gives a snapshot of what is required here. And generation of hydroelectric power, supply of electrical power for construction of transmission line towers, construction of electrical substation. So these are the things you can take a note of, that all those things develop revenue for a country. So you can see revenue here and how the country is generating the revenue. They provide electricity for you. The government provide you electricity. So they provide roads for you. They provide potable water and they provide wastewater pipes. Like that, these facilities are given by the government and these facilities are being used by the consumers. So if you develop the infrastructure, and definitely the people are going to use that, and if the people are using that, they will be taxed. So more the facilities are there and more advanced facilities are there, the people are going to utilize that, and you can serve those to other country and a country can generate revenue. So this is how to become a developed country. So if we are not concentrating on infrastructure, we are not going to improve our lifestyle and we are not going to improve the development of a country. So this is a process. This is not a single day work. Constantly we have to work in each and every field of the development. So if you work, then our country will also develop. Okay, so this with this I conclude this session. So now you will be knowing what is civil engineering by this session. Some lights on this is being given in this class, and why civil engineers came and why engineering came, you would be knowing that. And what happens for all this infrastructure facilities, only engineers are the person who can make this into possible. No doctors can work, no commerce and lawyers and other people, accountant, these people can make. So they cannot make the country to the next level. So you people are engineers and you can make our society a better society, our India a better India to live. So you can make that change. So what are the requirement of the people currently? You have to identify that, and for that requirement, if you are making an engineering solution, that is topmost solution from your side, then you will be developing and your country will be developing along with you. So due to a Jio, that is due to Reliance Ambani, so you can say that. So by Ambani's philosophy and by Ambani's work and his industry, India got developed. Not even he is developing, India is also developing. So like that it works. So if he is developing and if he is making revenue, he is going to pay tax, and definitely a country will get gain due to these people. And without engineers, he cannot run. So this is what the way the things work. I hope you enjoyed this session.